Good evening, TradeFlare family. Welcome to the Nightly Breakdown, where we break down what happened today in the stock market, as well as give you an idea of what we're looking at into tomorrow.
So let's head over to the key points. And the first key point that I want to talk about today is CPI digestion and how the market took today's CPI report.
And I had mentioned last night on the breakdown that if we saw some higher inflation, that didn't mean that the market would crash, but instead the market was expecting inflation.
We did see some sort of volatile reaction. We saw a wide range today,
but the overall biggest thing that stood out about the digestion was the fact that the banks were up and then they sold off really quick. Now, the banks have been winners in inflation because they win either way, but they really win when we have high rates. And this inflation data was sort of high, but it wasn't high enough. And this kind of proves my theory that the market was already expecting inflation, so they didn't really react. The market actually took the report in a positive manner.
It touched highs on the S&P today.
And overall closed pretty solid on all three indices.
Now, one thing I want to make note of is that AMC was down today, and they didn't really make much noise.
And neither did crypto.
Don't take your eye off these yet. The inflation proved there's a lot of money in the markets right now. There's a lot of money floating around.
We're in an environment where anything can pop.
Now, as far as going into the rest of the week, I really want to watch tech, real estate, and healthcare.
I think the market can kind of take a breather after getting the CPI data.
And the tech companies have been really banking on rates staying low.
And the real estate industry would always love for rates to be low.
I also want to see where the commodities stand tomorrow, where steel, oil.
Now that we have inflation proven at a certain number, I think we can start to react and some of these companies can start to go.
These travel plays and these reopening plays that have kind of been muffled by the inflation talks.
So I think these could start to run.
So let's head over and look at the SPY and see where we're at, where we went today, and where we could be going tomorrow.
So just like last night, I'm looking at the 15-minute chart.
And one thing I want to point out is that we broke above, we looked above and went, and therefore we would have targeted the double of the range. So we would have targeted 424.69, and we went pretty close to there, found some resistance. We were only like 6 cents off, so we kind of knew right then and there was when the sellers were coming in.
This was definitely some emotional buying in the morning, but it was a breakout, and we did expect to go to those levels if we broke out.
We did expect a big move with the CPI data.
I want to point out how we remained in a bull trend throughout the whole day. Even through that dip, we did not break back through our 6.8 retracement of our overnight range, which is bullish in my opinion.
And as it lies after hours, this is looking like it's ready to break out of this bullish pennant like pattern.
If we do break out and break above that range doubled around 424.69,
sort of blue skies territory from there,
that's when we start to look for continuation patterns like bull flags forming and we play the breaks.
If we do see sell side action, we'll look at our levels in the morning.
As far as I stand right now, I stand sort of bullish to sideways for the rest of the week.
So let's head over to the watch list, and the first stock I have on the watch list is Amazon.
And looking at the daily, this is a big candle on some big volume.
Now, some of these options are pretty expensive, but we could have a nice play lining up for us on a Friday like tomorrow.
And after the data being out of the way, I think we can see these big names start to move,
especially because this one has news and rumors of a stock split coming up.
And I've also heard rumors that it's going to be getting added to the Dow.
And I think it's starting to move, so I want to be able to get in before that happens.
If you notice what I have drawn here on the 15-minute chart, this is a pressure cooker top.
And this thing broke out exactly how I expected it to towards the end of the day.
I really think it'll continue into tomorrow.
Next up is Airbnb, and I think these travel stocks have been muted by all the inflation data and the news.
I think Airbnb will have some great earnings in the upcoming quarter.
Another thing I want to point out is the fact that we're still near lows.
And last week we made our first bullish move, and this week we kind of made our first bullish retracement. We found some support, we found some buyers yesterday and today,
and now I think we can continue to go higher.
Tomorrow I'll be looking to trade this one off of today's range.
Next up, I want to look at Square,
and looking at the 1 hour, I really do like this one.
Notice I always have my necklines here in yellow, and this is the neckline of this previous reverse head and shoulders that broke out. We retested it and is now acting as support.
I think if we break above 218, I think we can start to go a lot higher.
This is also a play off of a lot of spending
and the crypto bounce,
so I think we could see these fintech companies start to go.
Also watching PayPal, Visa, and MasterCard.
So headed over to the TradeFlare fam suggestions.
The first one I have today is ACST or Costi Pharma.
I don't really know anything about this stock specifically, but technically it doesn't look very bad. It
looks like a biotech, and it looks like it's rounding on the bottom, kind of like a cup and handle.
This is telling us that the sellers have been trying and trying to take this thing lower, but the buyers have been consistent. There's volume here to pick it up. There's long-term investors.
And if you look at my yellow line here, this is a neckline. If we're looking at a triple bottom here.
So yeah, watch Acosti Pharma. This one could be good. I don't really know anything about what news is coming up or what type of catalyst this could have, but there are a lot of biotechs that have a lot of big catalysts coming up here in the month of June, so watch out for this. The next TradeFlare fam suggestion is SDIV, and this is a super dividend ETF, and I've never personally traded or seen it before. And upon doing some shallow research, this thing has a lot of huge dividend paying companies. Not huge companies, but dividends are huge. It seems this thing tracks the performance with the dividends implied. Like we've been talking about, everybody wants value right now. Everybody wants dividends. Now, looking at it on the technical side of things and looking at the option chain, this isn't something that I would actually trade. But as far as momentum goes, this thing is on a roll. But as far as the option chain goes, there's no liquidity and nobody's trading the options. So as far as the SDIV goes, I'm using this to look and see if investors are really chasing after that dividend. This could tell us a lot about where the money is going and what to expect for 2021. So that wraps up tonight's nightly breakdown. If you got value out of this video, make sure you hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss a nightly breakdown or a weekly watch list. If you're new to trading and you're looking to get in on all this action, check out the link in the description and join our Discord to upgrade to TradeFlare Pro. And remember, we're not financial advisors, nor do we claim to be. Stock market is risky and you could lose money, so use the information in these videos at your sole discretion. Don't forget that time is your most valuable asset, so quit wasting it. Get up, get out, and go get it, my friend.